Good morning, students. Today we will start lesson number 21, A New Dawn, Module 1. In the previous chapter, you have studied about the changes took place in a country after independence, the form of government, that is the democratic government, and about our constitution. Now, in this chapter, we are going to study about Indian Union, functions of the central and the state government, the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. Indian Union. India is a very vast country. It is divided into states and the union territories, and all these states and the union territories are together called the Indian Union. There are 28 states and 8 union territories in India. Look at the map of India. Here you can see 28 states and 8 union territories along with their capitals and union territory capital Delhi. Rajasthan is the largest state and Goa is the smallest state in India. Union territories. In India, there are 8 union territories. These are small regions termed as separate states and they are governed by Lieutenant Governor. Let us see their names one by one. Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Daman and Diu and Dadar and Nagar Haveli, Chandigarh, Lakshadweep Islands, Puducherry, Delhi, Ladakh, Jammu and Kashmir. Lakshadweep is the smallest union territory. In India, there is a dual government, the central government and the state government. Central government is also known as union government. It comprises the president, the vice president, the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. The parliament has two houses, the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. So let us talk about the Lok Sabha first. It is also known as the lower house or the house of people. The leader of the house is the prime minister. The members are directly elected by the people. Maximum members that can be elected are 552. The term is of 5 years. A citizen of India above 25 years of age can contest the election. The president can dissolve the Lok Sabha. Rajya Sabha. It is also known as the upper house. It is headed by the vice president. Its members are not directly elected by the people. They are elected by the members of the state legislative assembly. It can have up to 250 members, 238 elected and 12 nominated. And these 12 nominated members are elected by the president. The members of the Rajya Sabha are elected for a period of 6 years. 1/3 of the members retire after every 2 years and fresh members are elected. Now let us see the difference between Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha in a tabular form. Lok Sabha. It is also known as the lower house. It consists of 552 members. Its members are directly elected by the people. The term is of 5 years. It can be dissolved by the president. Rajya Sabha. It is also known as the upper house. It consists of 250 members. Its members are elected by the elected members of the state legislative assembly. The term is of 6 years. It cannot be dissolved. It is a permanent house. And Lok Sabha is more powerful than Rajya Sabha. State government. Every state has a state legislative assembly. The party that wins the election forms the government and its leader is called the chief minister. Members are known as MLAs. MLAs means member of the legislative assemblies. The head of the state is the governor. He or she is appointed by the president for a period of 5 years. So let us summarize what we have studied. India has 28 states and 8 union territories. All the states and the union territories are called Indian Union. India has a dual government, the central and the state government. The parliament has two houses, the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. The state government has the state legislative assemblies. The governor governs the state along with the chief minister and the council of ministers. Union territories are governed by lieutenant governor. So that was all for today. Happy learning.